asking no questions in Jericho Mouk.
Please.
We are here today to officially launch Scotia Bank Intercol Championship 2017. Secondly, to give general information to the public about our plans to host the games at the National Athletics Stadium. And thirdly, to give clear explanations about our expectations to the students and our faithful patrons. We are going to have brief remarks from Mr. Dominic Jeremiah, from Mr. Stoll Lyons, from Mr. Colin Peters, and from Superintendent Vanny Corwin. So to get us out of the starting blocks, we're going to ask Mr. Dominic Jeremiah to come. Mr. Jeremiah.
Once again, I want to take this opportunity to welcome my colleagues on the head table, colleague principals, members of the media. We are especially grateful for your presence here today. And we just want to thank everyone for being here. Welcome. As we officially launch Intercol 2017, I think it is fitting that we first of all recognize the invaluable contribution that our title sponsor, Scotiabank, has made towards the development of Intercol, the Intercol Championship, over the last 37 years. We want to thank them for recommitting themselves to the development of youth, especially in the area of track and field. All of our top track and field athletes, like Kirani James, Aline Francique, Rondell Bartholomew, Anderson Peters, Hazelan Regis, just to name a few, have been nurtured through the intense competition these games have provided over the last 52 years. The Grenada Association of principals of secondary school, through the local organizing committee, the Grenada Secondary School Games Association, is extremely proud of this successful collaboration with our sponsors. The Grenada Athletic Association, the Royal Grenada Police Force, the media, the Stadium Authority, the Ministry of Sports, the Ministry of Education, all our schools, our parents, patrons, and the student athletes who make this experience a memorable one every year. Intercol is first and foremost about reinforcing fundamental education values that we emphasize in our classroom. It is about hard work, discipline, being gracious losers and modest winners. It is about honesty and obedience, but ultimately it is about fortitude, love of school, and love of country. The number one goal for Intercol 2017 is to focus on the development and care of our athletes. One way to ensure the development of our Intercol Championship is through the introduction of new events. In order to manage the development of our athletes, we had to make the inevitable decision to add a third day to the Intercol. This was necessary to give the athletes sufficient time for recovery and to facilitate a more efficient management of the games. The games director will give more information about the new events. We want to ensure that the Intercol Championship is executed in an efficient and incident-free manner. In order to accomplish this, we want students and patrons to conduct themselves in a disciplined manner before, during, and after the games. All students must be in full school uniform. They must carry their IDs at all times, obey the instruction of their principals and teachers, and the instruction of the police and other significant adults. Since this is a school event, no one is permitted to come to the stadium with alcohol, drugs, or weapons. Students must not tamper with any equipment in the National Stadium or engage in any inappropriate behavior. INTERCOL will be streamed around the world, and there will be visitors here for the Grenada Invitational. So we must work to ensure that we are at our best. When students enter the stadium, they will remain there until the games end, and then they must go straight home. INTERCOL 2017 will be held officially on April 3rd, 4th, and 5th. This year, we have made an accommodation for the Grenada Invitational by moving the games to start on Monday instead of Tuesday to give our local athletes time for recovery and our international athletes access to the track. There will not be a day for field events. And I repeat, there will not be a day for field events. All the events will be distributed evenly over 3 days. So it is critical that students and patrons are here for 3 days. The price of admission will be the main pavilion lower level, $30. We are encouraging patrons to purchase a season ticket at $80 for the 3 days. They buy an individual ticket, they will pay $30. The secondary pavilion will be $20. If they purchase a season ticket for 3 days, they'll pay $50. The bleachers, we propose to sell the tickets to our students. Day one, $5. Day two, $10. Day three, $15. If they purchase the season ticket, they pay $25. Our athletes will be housed in the top right-hand corner of the secondary stand. Tickets for students will be available at the schools and for adults at outlets to be named later. This year's INTERCOL will celebrate its 52nd year of existence, and our sponsors have opened the door to non-financial partners to join us to ensure the sustainability and the development of INTERCOL. We trust that the private sector will come on board to support sports development in our trial and states. We honor our dedicated technical staff of volunteers, officials, committed teachers in our schools, coaches, other volunteers, members of the media, the police, the medical staff, the athletes, and the patrons who have remained committed to this endeavor over these many years. On behalf of the Grenada Association of Secondary School Principals, we want to express our deepest gratitude to all those who have worked and continue to work to serve INTERCOL over the years. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Jeremiah. And now we are going to have brief remarks from Mr. Stoll Lyons.
Thank you, and let me take the opportunity again to welcome panelists, principals, all. Scotiabank is very proud, extremely proud, to be sponsoring the Scotiabank Intercol for yet another year. It represents 37 years of continuous sponsorship, and Scotiabank has been in Grenada only 50 years. I say only. So it speaks to our commitment to this event, Intercol. And this year, as you've heard from the Games Director, this year promises to be another big year. The committee alluded to new events, and you'll hear that from Curlin a little later, new events that will include hurdles, the prep field events, and it really gives our local athletes an opportunity to showcase all their talents. This is very much in line with Scotiabank's vision for its customers, our philosophy being to build a lasting relationship with our customers in the areas that we do business. And through partnerships like these, we propose to give back to our communities. Our sponsorship will continue to focus on bringing opportunities to young people and building strong communities through sport by teaching the importance of teamwork and camaraderie. This agenda of ours to sponsor youth development does not stop at Intercol. We continue to look for the opportunity wherever they present themselves. For over 17 years now, we've also partnered with the West Indies Cricket Board and the Grenada Cricket Association to successfully execute a kiddie cricket camp for the primary school at the primary school level. This year saw the participation of close to 90 primary school kids from 8 primary schools throughout Grenada. In December 2014, Scotiabank announced another very important partnership with CONCACAF Football, naming us as the official bank of the CONCACAF and the league's first official partner. The multi-year agreement includes support for youth events like men and women under 17, under 15, and under 20. Again, giving them an opportunity to demonstrate their skills and fine-tune these talents. This year, the event has grown beyond the realms of its normal framework. And as we've heard, it will be 3 days in 2017. I want to take the opportunity to encourage the general public to support all days, all 3 days of the event. We also invite Corporate Grenada to support and encourage them to reach out to the committee to figure out how they can help and benefit from jumping on board. Intercol in Grenada brings together the passion of our team at Scotiabank with the spirit and varying interests of our communities, and we look forward to a keenly contested event in 2017. Thank you to the principals, teachers, police, athletes, the media, and volunteers. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Lyons. And now we are going to have brief remarks from the meet director, Mr. Colin Peters.
My fellow members of the table, welcome, principal, CGE representative, Kwame Hippolyte, teachers, media. I'm excited. This is the Scotiabank Intercol 2017. I sat and I listened, and I thought after Grenville Intercol in Progress Park, we will not have a historical Intercol anymore. You know, last 2 years you also introduced the new events, the new categories, and it was all exciting. But to listen this year for the introduction of the new event and to hear some of the changes that will occur for INTERCOL 2017, I'm very happy of being part of being part of the activity. I must start by saying thanks to the Grenada Secondary School Games Association, to the head, to the chairman, Mr. Jeremiah, for his trust and confidence that he has put in me to direct the INTERCOL Games, Scotia Bank INTERCOL Games, for next year. Over the last 3 years, we have been made changes to the games. The aim is to assist athletes' participation, to get the most students to come out and participate in INTERCOL by giving each of the finalists points. We also help in the development of sports. We also help for the general care and welfare of the athletes, which is one of our main concern, the care and welfare of our athletes. It is important to make changes to assist in preparation of our athletes for regional and international meet. Therefore, a technical team was appointed and recommendation was made to the committee for 2017 INTERCOL Games. On that basis, I would like to inform the public that the 2017 INTERCOL Games Championship, Scotia Bank, will start on the 3rd of April 2017 to the 5th of April. So we go from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Someone may ask, well, why? And I must say I'm very happy. We all listened to the news and we all heard of the big name that will be participating in the Grenada Invitational that will happen on the 8th, take place on the 8th, which is the weekend of the Scotia Bank INTERCOL Games. We want to give the athletes the opportunity to compete on an international circuit with some of the athletes they have seen on television over the years and have dreamed and aspired to be like them. We want to give them the opportunity to compete and to be seen by many. With the new events, I must say we're starting is a developmental program with the preparatory, which is U14. We're introducing the field events for the first time, which I'm very excited about. For many years, we have schools like Bishop College that have been doing that event in under 40, and we have seen how they have done at INTERCOL Games. So the field events for the U14, the under 14, the preparatory, will be the javelin, the discus, and the shot put for male and female. For the sub-juniors, the U17, we're introducing the hurlers, so it'll be hurlers, 100 hurlers, for the girls, 400 hurlers for female. For the male, 110 hurlers, 400 hurlers for the male. In the juniors, both the hurlers for 110 female and 100 male. We also, the 400 meters will be introduced across the board. We heard of the concern of some of the principal about the juniors and the triple jump, so they'll be introducing the juniors triple jump, which used to be an open triple jump for the female. Also the 400 hurlers for the senior male. So the hurlers will be introduced across the board. And we have been supported over the years with a workshop from the Grenada Athletics Association and the Olympic Committee. We also bring a lecturer here from Barbados to run a Christmas program in the hurlers. This year we have done it, or the Olympic Committee have done it to the pole vault, which is an event in the future we may look to introduce. But I'm very happy to say that with the introduction of the event, it will help in the development of our sports, it will help to give better performance, and this is the area where we have to put some of our emphasis. We have seen the success over the years in the field events, and we know with the introduction at the U14 level, we'll get better performance when we reach the senior division. We must say that we are confident that the introduction of the new events will help in the development of sports in the particular events. The Monday, you may ask why the Monday, as the chairman mentioned, we in collaborating and giving support to the Grenada Invitational on the 8th of April. In closing, I want to inform the public that the 3 days is both track and field events. So as Mr. Jeremiah mentioned, the field events and the track events will be running both ways. Both days will be full excitement, finishing the release at the end. You know, we are asking you to come out and support with your usual colors, support your school, support the athletes. INTERCOL this year will be a bigger, better INTERCOL. It will be in line with the regional and international event. And not only that, we are making a big investment on the youths so that we can help to develop in all the technical aspects in the age group where they learn the most, so that we'll have better athletes compete in the future to represent our country. We want to thank you for the support, and we want to ask you to come out and support your school. We know of the rivalry between the GBSS and the SAS and the McDonald College and the Grenville Convent, St. Andrew's Anglican Secondary School, St. Joseph Convent, St. George's Anglican High Champion. We want Bishop College. We want you to come out and support the school, and come out and support your school, and let's see who's the champion for 2017. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Peters. And INTERCOL would not be as we would like it to be without the support and help of the Royal Grenada Police Force. So at this time, we're going to welcome Superintendent Vanny Cobbin to give some brief remarks.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and good evening to the head table, Principals Association, members of the media. The IFGPF is again pleased to be associated with INTERCOL for another year, 2017. We have had great success over the last few years, especially after the challenges we have had in St. Andrews 2 years ago. We have been able to build on the experiences gained from the challenges in St. Andrews, and so we have rolled out and improved our operational effectiveness last year, 2016. This year will be no exception. The Royal Grenada Police Force will be in full force, ensuring the safety and security of the venue, the officials, the athletes, and all of the patrons. We have already done our threat assessment is continuing. I am pleased to inform the public that our threat assessment, not only for INTERCOL games, but for any event in Grenada, is relatively low. This year is no exception. Our threat assessment is really low. We are not expecting any issues at all, but whatever issues that arise, we will be able to deal with it effectively as we have done in the past. All of our policies will be in place for INTERCOL 2017. Our drug policy, our weapons policy, alcohol and vending policy will be in effect. Our after-event security strategy that happens in and around the town of St. George's will be happening again this year, 2017. We have had a few challenges last year that we have strategized for 2017. We have been building our strategies and our operational effectiveness to encounter those, some of the challenges we have had last year. And I just want to assure the public that the venue for INTERCOL 2017 will be safer than it has been in any of the years prior. The introduction of the additional day requires more from the security, which we are prepared to put in. Our planning is ongoing, and by the time the games are here, you will feel the effectiveness of the police force. The 3 days in question, and the safety and security of the venue will be realized as we go through INTERCOL 2017. I want to take this opportunity to welcome all to the games, and feel safe and secure as you come out, because the police will be there to ensure your safety and your security. Thank you.
Very well. Thank you very much, Superintendent Cowan. And at this time, we're going to invite questions from the audience.
Probably Mr. Laz can let us know who was the sponsorship package for this year. And why are we inviting corporate Romania to photography? Is there a reduced budget?
No, actually, the reason why
Okay, so in 2017, we recognized and we got feedback from the, our approach to dealing with INTERCOL has always been an interaction with the committee to get feedback from them as to what they need. This year, the games have grown beyond the expectation of us all. And the idea is we do not want to create an environment that prevents the development of sports in Grenada. And we felt it best to give the opportunity to corporate Grenada to jump on board. It doesn't change our sponsorship in any way. We'll continue along that agenda.
And what's the package you're offering this year?
The package remains the, like I said, the package remains the same as prior years.
What's it?
We would not normally speak. The package would involve a monetary contribution as well as support from the team.
Are you going to disclose
that? No, we would not normally disclose that. All right. Year over year, I mean, and you could get, you could speak with the committee on that. Year over year, the expectation is that the cost associated with putting on Intercol has increased, and we have moved with those times. We've year over year increased our sponsorship to meet the demands of the Intercol committee, and it's our plan to do the same this year.
Mm-hmm.
Over the years, the sponsorship has been meeting the expectation of the team, and we're going to continue to do that. All right? Thankfully, we've been doing well, and we can continue to maintain that relationship with the committee.
Yeah, particularly last year, we have had a little issue with vandalism at the stadium. There were a few damages in the interior. This year, we will be strategizing for that a little differently. And so I don't want to give out what the strategy will be too early, but I feel comfortable saying I don't think we will have any of these issues this year, because we have changed our strategy to mitigate against whatever vandalism or issues that will arise for 2017.
Mr. You made no mention of traffic arrangements. How are you going to handle that?
Yeah, usually we would leave the traffic arrangement for a separate media briefing. You understand the importance of the one today is just to be very brief. So just to let you know that the police will be out and doing what we need to do. Our traffic arrangement will be put in place, and in time, way in time before the games, we will be rolling out our traffic arrangement for Intercol 2017, either on one behind the headlines or one of the other media programs. So we will be meeting the public and giving them an opportunity to question what needs to be or what will be for 2017.
Mm-hmm. What arrangements are in place for them this year?
Well, one of the things you would notice already is that our planning committee has started working earlier than usual. About 2 weeks ago, I personally called the principals in Karikou to engage them. And the purpose of that call was to try to find out what their needs are. Intercol, a significant part of our budget in Intercol has been allocated to Karikou. And that is not only a recent thing, that has always been the case. Now, last year we ran into a little challenge where the National Stadium decided that they were going to put into effect a new fire policy that they have. And as a result, Karikou was not able to cook in the stadium the way, using open flames, the way they had done in the past. And that created a little challenge last year. However, based on the conversations that I've had with my colleagues in Karikou, we will be continuing the conversation to ensure when Karikou comes here that they're well taken care of. I mean, the record is that Karikou has always been well taken care of. A little hiccups here and there like everybody else, but generally we want to ensure that Karikou is well cared for.
Are they coming as one unit or separate as?
As usual, they're coming separately. They most likely they are going to be housed in the National Stadium. We have already met with the Stadium Authority and discuss these matters. And the Stadium Authority always go out of their way to accommodate Karikou, to do their best, you know. And I expect the same to happen this year. So they're coming as separate schools. They may come down on the same boat together, probably, but they are going to compete separately. So that's it for Karikou.
Would that serve to eliminate some of the problems with the late and
Mm-hmm. Well, I think last year we had an issue that was a new issue. We had never had that issue before, where the meet manager system malfunctioned at the beginning of day one. And that had a negative effect on the, you could say, the smooth running of the game from the time that was scheduled for us to start, causing the games to go way into the night. Now, that is one of my primary concern. As a matter of fact, when we started the conversation with the meet director and even with the Grenada Athletic Association, I had a meeting with the Grenada Athletic Association. The goal was to try to make sure that our systems were in place so that we can avert something like that happening. In terms of challenges, we have never had a day one in the way that we are going to have a day one this time. We have had day one, for example, when we went to Progress Park, we had a day one of field events. That was easy to manage. The challenge we have had in the past is enticing not only our student population, but the general public to come out on day one. The way the games are structured now is that if you miss day one, you're going to be missing a lot because everything is integrated. So you're going to have field events, you're going to have track events, you're going to have relays on day one. Same thing will happen on day two, and of course on day three. So it is important that, and you will hear that coming through strongly in our promotion, we are encouraging all our students and of course our patrons to come out on day one, day two, and day three. We know what the economic challenges are for some of our students and patrons who live in the outer parishes. There are real economic issues there sometimes. But we are asking and we are begging that they come out. We have created packages as an incentive to entice our students and our patrons to come out on day one. So day one is going to be a new experience for all of us. Intercol is going to be a lot more costly than it has been because we are adding another day with everything attached to it. How we take care of our officials, you know, the persons who are coming that we have to, our dignitaries who are coming that we have to cater for, that is an additional cost. But we feel that in the interest of the development of Intercol, that the decision to go 3 days is inevitable.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It came about the fact that a number of our star athletes, they are leaving school at a very young age, mm-hmm. and enter into the camp system. There are talks that there should be an integration of them within the intersecondary school. Mm-hmm. Now that you're talking more competition and making it bigger and better, and so have the association had that discussion at all in terms of an integration of the athletes?
Great question. It came up last year, but I have good news for you this year. Already this year, we have had two very engaging conversations at the Principals Association level about TAMCC. TAMCC right now is on our agenda. What we are in the process of doing, instead of just having a knee-jerk reaction to bringing TAMCC in, we want to do it in a reasoned and, if I may say, a little scientific way. So that when TAMCC, and I'm using the expression when TAMCC comes, that there will be no doubt in anybody's mind that the way in which they are coming there is in an organized and reasoned way. So we are going to have, we have made a decision at the last principal's meeting that we are going to have something like a little symposium on TAMCC and their inclusion in the game. We didn't want to rush it and bring them in this year. We wanted to make sure we have the right conversation with the administration of TAMCC. We noticed that the conversation is on the periphery, but we haven't had an engaging conversation with the administration of TAMCC, because they are going to have to be involved in that conversation. So they are on the cards. I think I can confidently say that come next Intercol, we definitely probably would have TAMCC in, but we have to figure out how we're going to do that. We have a number of proposals on the table. One is to allow students to be attached to their schools and compete there. I don't think that's going down so well with the principals. Or allow TAMCC to come as a unit. They will not be able to compete, of course, in the wide range of events, but certainly they will be able to compete in the events within which the age group falls. So there's a lot of hope. I think that conversation is moving forward. But as I said, we don't want to just have a knee-jerk reaction because people are talking about TAMCC. We want to do it in a reasoned way. We have a concern about our young ladies, and we also have a concern about our young men, but particularly our young ladies, because we realize that they compete very well at Intercol, and sometimes they just vanish and they disappear. And we have a concern about that, trying to make sure that we sustain their training, their involvement in competition, and hopefully represent Grenada at the other levels.
Mm-hmm. Just to go back to Johnson's last question,
mm-hmm.
What cut of time are you aiming at on our trees?
Again, that's a conversation we have been having. I know I have had that conversation with Mr. Peters. On day one, we are hoping that we can end somewhere around 6:30. Why? We want to give the athletes sufficient time to rest and to recover for competition on day two. Hopefully we can have the same 6:30, 7 o'clock on day two. And of course, on day three, we probably would have to go a little later because we have the closing ceremony and all of those things that we do at the end of the day. So it's we heard a complaint coming from parents, and we heard some concerns expressed by the principals, particularly the principals from St. Patrick's, St. Andrew's, St. John's, about the time that students are getting home. And I made it very clear to the director that that's something, as principals, we're going to have to try to do our very best to honor, so that there isn't any issue.
But they have organized transport for the athletes?
They have organized transport, but you have to keep in mind that if Intercol ends at 8 o'clock, the bus probably gets back to Sotheby's, for example, at about 9. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean that the students are going to get to their homes at 9 o'clock, because some of them live off the road, you know?
So they are responsible to get them to their houses?
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, the persons who are responsible for the athletes, they do that. But we just want to ensure that we end early enough to give them sufficient time to get back to their respective homes. All right.
So any plans on engaging the bus associations? Because one of the problems on the night is that you always find police officers having to direct buses from other routes, especially to take children in the outer parishes. So
mm-hmm. Well, Superintendent hinted to the fact that there were one or two little hiccups last year. And I know that in our postmortem last year, that came up. I think we were looking at the possibility of establishing zones. And of course, that involves a conversation with the bus owners. That conversation will continue as we look at the security plan and roll out the security plan. and more information on that will be forthcoming. But we welcome the suggestion about engaging the bus association. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Yeah, in light of the new events that have been introduced into INTERCOL, are there any discussions with the athletics association and the ministry in terms of getting all the schools involved in the different programs?
You mean, when you say programs?
The hurdles and the
oh, INTERCOL never make any decision without involving the Grenada Athletic Association. As a matter of fact, part of the regiment that we go through when we plan every year is to meet with the Grenada Athletic Association. And we are, you know, all our schools are members of it. And so when we're thinking of development, we want to ensure that our plan is in sync with the Grenada Athletic Association so that we are not going in different direction, but that we are unified. So the pole vault workshop that was held in Grenada in December, INTERCOL was informed about that. The principals were informed about that because our students had to be involved. And I think it is important to state here that any development initiative, any conversation about track and field always involves the Grenada Athletic Association. As a matter of fact, just 2 weeks ago, I met with members of the Grenada Athletic Association to discuss a number of issues pertinent to track and field, and of course, INTERCOL. Good question. When we concluded INTERCOL at Progress Park 2 years ago, one of the suggestions that came from the postmortem was extending to the schools in St. Andrews and St. Patrick's and John's the idea of making arrangement to stay closer to the venue for 3 days. It makes logical sense, but that is not a matter that INTERCOL manages. That is a decision of each individual school. So for example, when we had INTERCOL up at Progress Park, Presentation College, as a school, made a decision that we wanted to stay closer to the venue. We had a conversation with the parents, with our teachers, and we made arrangement to stay up in St. Andrews, and it worked out beautifully. Now, we have put that on the table to principals when we met, and it is up to the principals, the individual principals, the coaching staff, the regular staff to make the decision whether they would like to do that or not. But INTERCOL, the way we manage CARICO and we deal with CARICO, INTERCOL is not taking on that responsibility to make arrangement for schools. Schools have to make that on their own. Yes?
I know Scotia Bank has been putting a lot of finances into it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Good question. Right. Now, after Ivan, for example, INTERCOL every year always had a challenge because we were trying to run INTERCOL. The expenses of INTERCOL were great, and we were never able to make a big enough profit to be able to redistribute back to the development of our athletes in the various schools. Now, within the last couple of years, coming out of Progress Park was a major challenge. We basically operated at a loss. We were in the red coming out of Progress Park. We came into the National Stadium, and we basically was trying to pay our bills and stay afloat. I think one of the reasons why we are moving in the direction and our sponsors have opened up to the idea is that we feel going forward, it is very important, the sponsors share the view too, that this care of our athletes and the development of our athletes is very much on the table for us. As a matter of fact, we met with the bank just recently, and that was a very lengthy discussion that we held. We have done things over the years to help schools, but nothing really significant. And we are hoping that if we can make a profit out of Intercol, that money will go back into the development of our athletes. So that is the goal. So certainly, within the last 2 years, we've been seeing signs that if this is managed properly, if we have more sponsors on board, that there is a likelihood that we can make a profit to support our athletes. But as opposed to some view that Intercol probably makes a lot of money and the money is stored somewhere in Switzerland, I don't know, it's a joke, because essentially what we have been trying to do is to make sure that we have this event every year. We manage it properly. We take care of all the persons that we're supposed to take care of. And if there's anything in the kitty, it goes back to the development of. We haven't been able to do that effectively. So the goal going forward is to try to see if we can accomplish that. We owe it to our athletes and to our schools. Yes, sir. Well, I think as it stands right now, you remember there was a time when there was no other sponsors allowed in. I think because Scotia Bank is a financial institution, I don't want to speak for Scotia Bank, but I'm assuming based on the conversations that we have behind closed doors, that bringing financial sponsors on board may be setting up a challenge for them in terms of competition. So I don't see that happening in the immediate future. However, I think I want to express my gratitude to the bank for, you know, listening to our plea over the years to open up for non-financial sponsors to come on board. Because you see, Intercol, what we want to do with Intercol, we would never be able to do it effectively if we do not allow other sponsors to come on board and to support the issues, those things that we do at Intercol. So this is a historic year, and as Mr. Lyon said, we're hoping that we have some conversations taking place behind the scenes. We hope they bear good fruit, but we'll let you know.
Final question.
Yes, sir.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Is that going to continue next year, or are we looking at a revision?
No, But before I say that, let me make this point, because I raised it with the minister when I met with him. For the last 3 years, Intercol has had to make an accommodation for a number of things happening. We, as a principals association, have made the decision that from next year, we want to have a fixed date for Intercol. And anybody else who is having anything would have to adjust, because we have been making accommodation. And of course, the Grenada Invitational, we felt it was a new thing, something with great potential, and we made the accommodation. But the reason why we had to go to Progress Park, you remember? And we all went there is because we had to make an accommodation. And we have had to make other accommodations in the past. CONCACAF women's thing, we had to make an accommodation. We prefer to have Intercol start on Tuesday for logistical reasons, okay? It means that it gives us a normal working day to get our business in order to begin competition on Tuesday. Now, what will happen is that some of us will have to work on Saturday and on Sunday to get ready for Intercol on Monday. But our dear friend, Mr. Bascom, is here. We are hoping if, by making this accommodation, whatever profits come from the Grenada Invitational would be shared with Intercol to help with the development of our athletes. All right.
Mr. Peters, don't think you're getting away. I have a question for you, sir.
All right.
I know over the years there have been concerns about injuries of athletes. How prevalent is this?
Well, injuries could occur on many for many reasons. Poor coaching theory, do not put in the work that is required, so they do not have a full preparation period. It should start at least by September. Poor diet, overwork of the athletes. So many reasons can cause injury. What we are, if you hear the theme for this year, is athlete care and welfare. So what we are doing and what we have been doing when we meet with the principal to speak about the care of the athletes. And as we have been advising them to assist the athletes, assist the students, you know, sometimes with meals, with the nutritional aspect. You know, if you start early with an athlete, I'm a coach by profession, I start early with my athletes in September, I will know who need help and what help that will require so that they can get the best performance at the time when it's needed. So it's getting in touch with the athletes and knowing what assistance they need instead of overworking the athlete and injuries occur.
Yeah, speaking of overworking, because you will see there are some athletes who would compete in a number of races, the one, the two, the four, even the 1500.
Yeah, well, it comes down against the first one, the coaching, your coaching ability or your coaching educational background or the understanding of the athlete. I have athletes before. We could call a couple of names, Joel, Philip, Kurt and Linda, that I may do 6 and 7 events. They are no world-class athletes during the Catalan event. So it's being able to assess your athlete and to be able to know what they need, what is the need at an early age. So it's, as I mentioned, Intercol is a historical event. To be part of it and to listen to the discussion on that have been required and been speaking about for years. We're getting other sponsorship on board. And the growth of the events, we have been saying over the years that we are matching up with Jamaica Boys and Girls Champ and Trinidad, but I think right now we are right there. With the 3 full days and with the opportunity to go and to give back to the school and to the athletes, I think we're on the right track. Thank you.